نبرات شعري فطرت.
نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم، أما بعد، قال الله تبارك وتعالى: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. رب هب لي حكما وألحقني بالصالحين، واجعل لي لسان صدق في الآخرين، واجعلني من ورثة جنة النعيم، واغفر لأبي إنه كان من الضالين، ولا تخزني يوم يبعثون، يوم لا ينفع مال ولا بنون، إلا من أتى الله بقلب سليم. صدق الله العظيم. مولاي صل وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم. I've recited before you verse 83 of Surah Al-Shu'ara, which is in the 19th juz of the Quran Kareem. Almighty Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala refers to the five du'as of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wa salam. We should memorize this du'a and we should ponder upon the deep meanings contained in this du'a. The first du'a, Rabbi habli hukman wa alhibni bis-salihin. O Allah, you grant me knowledge. Allah, you grant me wisdom and join me with the pious servants. The second dua, waj'al li lisana sidqin fil akhirin. O Allah, grant me a truthful tongue in the coming generations. Leave for me a true legacy in the coming generations. The third dua, وَاجْعَلْ لِي مِنْ وَرَسَةِ جَنَّةِ النَّعِيمِ. Allah, make me among the heirs of Jannatul Na'im. May Allah make every one of us the heirs and inheritors of Jannatul Na'im. The fourth dua, وَاغْفِرْ لِأَبِي إِنَّهُ كَانَ مِنَ الضَّالِّينَ. O Allah, forgive my father, for indeed he is among the deviated ones. This dua, Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam made before Almighty Allah tabarak wa ta'ala prohibited him for making dua from his father, for he was among the mushrikeen. The fifth dua, وَلَا تُخْزِنِي يَوْمَ يُبْعَثُونَ يَوْمَ لَا يَنْفَعُ مَالُ وَلَا بَنُونَ. O Allah, do not disgrace me. Allah, do not humiliate me on that day when people will be resurrected. On that day, with the wealth of a person and the children of a person will not avail him. Illa man atallaha biqalbin salim. The only thing that will avail a person on the day of Qiyamah will be when a person presents himself before Almighty Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala with a qalbun salim, with a pure and a sound heart. In the fifth dua, there is prescription for eternal success, and that is to inculcate within ourselves qalbun salim, a pure and a sound heart. The last 10 days of the month of Ramadan is freedom and emancipation from the fire of Jahannam. Every night in the last 10 nights of the month of Ramadan, Almighty Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala frees, liberates, emancipates thousands of souls from the fire of Jahannam and grant them entrance into Jannah. We make dua, Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala also frees us, decrees for us freedom and emancipation from the fire of Jahannam, and Almighty Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala grant every one of us entrance into Jannah and make us heirs from Jannatul Na'im. There are two prescriptions for Qalbun Salim. One is to have the correct aqidah, to have the correct belief. We are from the Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah. I repeat, we are from the Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah. That is a correct aqidah and that is a correct belief. A person with qalbun salim would be from the Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah. Ahl Sunnah means people who follow the Sunnah of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Whatever Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told to do, we do and we follow. And Jama'ah refers to the great illustrious Sahaba of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We must be very, very careful that we protect our aqidah, we correct our belief, and we remain with the Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah. The second aspect of Qalbun Salim is to have a pure and a sound heart. Remove all dirt, remove filth, remove enmity and animosity from our hearts. When we remove the dirt and filth from our hearts, then we will feel that closeness with Almighty Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala. In one hadith, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam reported to have mentioned to Hazrat Anas radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Ya Bunay, إن قدرت أن تصبح وتمسي وليس في قلبك غش لأحد فافعل. Oh my son, if it is possible to spend the morning and the evening in such a way that there's no ill feeling in your heart for the next person, then let that be so. يا بني, oh my son, Nabi Kareem Sahib has mentioned, this is my sunnah. To keep the heart pure and clean, that's my way of life. And that person, وَمَنْ أَحَبَّ سُنَّتِي فَقَدْ أَحَبَّنِي. That person who loves my sunnah, he's the one that really loves me. وَمَنْ أَحَبَّنِي كَانَ مَعِي فِي الْجَنَّةِ. And that person who loves me, he will be with me in Jannah and Paradise. So if we want to be in the close to Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Jannah and Paradise, inculcate within ourselves qalbun salim. Remove dirt, remove ill feelings, remove animosity from our hearts. If a pot is clean, if you put clean water will come out from it. But if the pot is dirty, you put clean water in it, then clean water will also become contaminated. We do so much of ibadat, but when our hearts are dirty and filthy, there's ill feeling in our heart for the next person, we will not realize the true effect of our ibadat. So, in the last night of month of Ramadan, we'll be exerting ourselves, inshallah, in the ibadat of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. But in order to realize the true effect of our ibadat, we want our hearts to shine, we want qalbun salim, then remove the ill feelings, remove that animosity, remove that enmity that we have in our heart for the next person, so that we realize the true effect of our ibadat. This was the great sunnah of the Sahaba. The Sahaba, if they had any misunderstanding with each other, they would always address it with each other, keep their heart pure and clean, and then they would see the real effect of the ibadat and being able to connect with Almighty Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala. May Allah Tabarak grant every one of us qalbun salim, pure, clean heart. We prepare ourselves now with a clean heart for the last night of the month of Ramadan, so that when we exert ourselves in our ibadat of Allah, no conscience is worrying us, nothing is of concern to us. We know we are connecting with Almighty Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala without any impediment, without any obstacles in our hearts, and we get the marifat and the recognition of Almighty Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala. May Allah grant every one of us pure, clean heart, and may Allah Ta'ala grant us the tawfiq to now search for Laylatul Qadr in the last night of the month of